are going to think about sphere. Okay, so everybody knows sphere. So what is mean by sphere? If we are going to make a definition of sphere, then what is the definition of sphere? The set of points in space, set of points in space which are equidistant from a fixed point, is called sphere. Okay, we will see practically what is sphere. Understood? So see here, I have a model of sphere. Understood? See here, there is no any flat surface. Okay, totally curved surface. Understood? Totally curved surface. So total surface area and curved surface area are same for a sphere. Okay, total surface area and curved surface area, because there is only curved surface area. Okay, so here we are going to calculate how to find out curved surface area of sphere. Understood? So everybody knows that diameter, radius. Radius means what? The distance from the center of sphere to the circumference or border. That distance is known as radius. Okay, suppose I will take a cut exactly in between. I will take a cut, then I will get this sphere will be converted into two identical parts. Okay, from that each part is known as hemisphere. This is hemisphere, this is also hemisphere. Okay, two hemispheres are there. Understood? So now this is sphere. Okay, and now we are going to calculate about total surface area. Okay, or curved surface area of the sphere. Okay, so for that one activity, experimental method we are going to use. For that one activity we are going to do, that is, I am going to wrap thread to whole surface area, total surface area. Okay, but only we need to take care that that thread should not overlap on each other. Okay, I have done one for that. So see here, this is a sphere, and we are going to wrap a thread to all the total surface area. Understood? So see here, that I have done here, this is that model, and see here I have taken the thread. Understood? Okay, we have to take care that it should not overlap on each other. Understood? Total surface area I have included in that. Okay, total surface area I have included in that. Understood? As well as with this, I have to take some circles. I have taken here circles whose each of them radius of this circle and this sphere should be exactly same. Understood? I don't know, I have taken the radius, whatever radius of this sphere, and this I have taken here circles, some circles I have taken here. Understood? So with the help of these two things we are going to use this. Understood? Afterwards this activity you have to do in the lab manual book. Okay, so now see what I am going to do here. I am going to remove this thread. Okay, I am going to remove this thread, and that I am going to fix on this circle. Okay, first I will start here, I will remove this and I will start here. Okay, then if thread is remaining, second circle I will use. If again it is remaining, third circle, fourth circle, fifth circle, how much it is required, that much I am going to do. Understood? So with the help of this activity we are able to derive the formula for the total surface area or curved surface area of sphere. Okay, so let's see. Okay, see here, this way we will remove this thread from the sphere. Okay, we will remove this slowly, and then this I am going to fix on the circles which we have taken of the same radius. Understood? So slowly here also we need to take care that this thread should not overlap on each other. Understood? So like that, how many circles are required, that much we will use. Okay, so the activity we have to keep going on. Okay, this way I have taken whole thread. Now this is empty completely, and this 1, 2, 3 and fourth one circle is going on. Okay, so this now I am taking here whatever remaining part for the fourth circle, taken here, and that now this is the fourth circle is completed. Okay, like that, how many circles are there, sir? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, whole entire this thread I have taken here and completely thread is used with the help of this activity. See, the radius of each one circle is same as the radius of this sphere. Okay, so here we can conclude, we can say that the area of one circle is pi r square. Area of one circle is pi r square. Then how many circles are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so what is the total surface area? 4 pi r square. Understood? 4 into pi r square equals to 4 pi r square. So total surface area or curved surface area of circle is 4 pi r square. Understood? One more thing we are going to see here, that is C. Hemisphere, total surface area of hemisphere. Okay, hemisphere means see, this total surface area is 4 pi r square. 4 pi r square, understood? If I will take half of that is hemisphere, so this area will be 2 pi r square. Understood? 2 pi r square. 2 pi r square plus this area, this is one circle. Okay, so this is pi r square. Pi r square. So total is 3 pi r square. Understood? So this is the hemisphere. This is about hemisphere. Okay, and total surface area is TSA. Total surface area is equal to the area of four circles, that is pi r square multiplied by 4, because four identical circles are there. Understood? So total surface area is equal to 4 pi r square, and hemisphere area to hemisphere TSA of hemisphere is equal to 3 pi r square. Understood? And curved surface area of hemisphere is equal to 2 pi r square. If we are not going to include this, then this area will be 2 pi r square. Understood? So for examples, we are going to use total surface area 4 pi r square and curved surface area of hemisphere. Hemisphere is equals to what we will use? Only 2 pi r square. Okay, so these formulas we are going to use to find out the solutions depend on the sphere. Okay. Today we are going to see some problems which are depend on the surface area of sphere. Okay, just now we have seen one activity, that is how to find out total surface area, that is surface area of sphere, surface area of hemisphere and total surface area of hemisphere. Okay, once again we will put a glance on surface area. Okay, so surface area, how to find out surface area of sphere. What is the formula to find out surface area of sphere? That is 4 pi r square. Okay, that is 4 pi r square. Understood? This formula we are going to use for total surface area. Surface area of hemisphere. Total surface area. Okay, this is first formula which we are going to use. Second is curved surface area of hemisphere. Curved surface area, that is CSA, curved surface area of hemisphere. Curved, only curved surface area here we are going to think. So that is curved surface area of hemisphere is equal to 2 pi r square. Okay, half of this, 2 pi r square. Okay, and one more thing, that is TSA, total surface area, TSA of hemisphere. TSA of hemisphere is equals to curved surface area, this plus area of the circle. Understood? So that is 2 pi r square plus pi r square. 2 pi r square plus pi r square is equal to 3 pi r square. Okay, so these three formulas we are going to use. Okay, surface area, that is total surface area, and curved surface area. Okay, that is same for a sphere. So that is 4 pi r square. Curved surface area of hemisphere, only curved surface area. Okay, so that will be 2 pi r square, half of this, and total surface area means curved surface area plus area of circle, that is base of hemisphere. So that is pi r, 2 pi r square pi r plus pi r square is equal to 3 pi r square. So these three formulas we are going to use to solve the problems which are depend on the surface area of sphere. Okay, so our first problem is find the surface area of sphere of radius 7 cm. Surface area of sphere. Surface area here given. Surface area means here we have to find out total surface area. Okay. So, surface area of sphere of radius 7 cm. Radius is given. What is the radius? 7 cm. Okay. Radius, that is R. R is equals to 7 cm. Understood? So,
surface area of sphere, if we are using that is S, capital S for surface area of sphere, S is equal to 4 pi r square. Okay, this is basic example which is depend on the only one concept. So directly here we have to use the value of radius, pi value we have to put 22/7. So 4 multiplied by 22/7 into radius is, what is the radius given? 7 centimeter. So 7 into 7 centimeter square. Okay, so here we can cancel this 7 and 7. So here what is remaining? 22 fours are 88, 88 multiplied by 7 centimeter square. Okay, so 88 sevens are 616 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the surface area of sphere. Okay, surface area of sphere we have to use 4 pi r square. S is the surface area. Understood? So this is 4 multiplied by value of pi is 22/7 multiplied by 7 into 7, because radius they have given us directly. So just we have to put the values, then you will get the answer. That is 616 centimeter square is the answer. Okay. Okay, so our second problem is find the surface area and total surface area of a hemisphere of radius 21 centimeter. Okay, radius is given 21 centimeter. Understood? And they are asking surface area and surface area of hemisphere. Surface area and total surface area. Okay, surface area and total surface area. Surface area means curved surface area, and total surface area means what will it will come? Curved surface area plus area of the circle, that is the base. Understood? So these two formulas we are going to use. Understood? So here radius is given 21 centimeter, r is given 21 centimeter. Understood? So with the help of this we have to find out surface area. So first we will take surface area of hemisphere, CSA, that is curved surface area of hemisphere is equal to, we have to use 2 pi r square, because only curved surface area here we have to take. So that is 2 multiplied by 2 into 22/7, radius is given 21 multiplied by 21 into centimeter square. Okay, so here we can find out easily, 7 ones are 7, 7 threes are 21. Okay, so 22 twos are 44 multiplied by 21 into 3, 63 centimeter square. Okay, so this product is the curved surface area of hemisphere or surface area of hemisphere. So that product is 2772 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the curved surface area. What did everybody? Curved surface area means if this is hemisphere, we have to think this area only. And in total surface area of hemisphere, in that we need to include the area of this base, area of this base also. So that will come in total surface area. So that also we are going to find out now. So total surface area, TSA of hemisphere, TSA of hemisphere is equals to what? Which formula we will use? 2 pi r square plus pi r square, that is 3 pi r square. So 3 pi r square. So is equal to 3 multiplied by value of pi is 22/7 multiplied by radius is same 21 into 21 centimeter square. So here again 7 threes are 21, 22 threes are 66 multiplied by 63 centimeter square. Okay, so this product will come 4158 centimeter square. Okay, so this is the total surface area of hemisphere. Got it everybody? The difference between this curved surface area means we have to calculate this only. Only curved surface, and in total surface area, this curved surface area as well as this area, area of the base or that circle. So that is 3 pi r square we have taken. So 3 multiplied by 22/7 into 21 multiplied by 21. So that product 66 into 63 will be 4158. Okay. So that is the total surface area, and this is curved surface area. Okay. These examples are depend on the basic concept. Okay. Slowly we will see different type of examples. Okay. Okay. Our third problem is the radius of a hemispherical balloon increases from 7 cm to 14 cm as air is being pumped into it. Find the ratios of the surface areas of the balloon in two cases. Okay, see here, once again I am reading this. The radius of a hemispherical balloon increases from 7 cm to 14 cm. Okay, first time suppose that balloon, when radius is 7 cm, that time balloon is like that. Suppose radius is here 7 cm and when radius is 14 cm, in second case radius is 14 cm. Okay, because air is being pumped into it. Okay, so there is a change in the radius. Understood? Then find the ratios of the surface areas of the balloon in two cases. Okay, we have to find out surface area. Surface area means here definitely this is balloon and air is being pumped into it, means it is closed. Understood? So we have to think about total surface area, TSA of this balloon and TSA of that balloon. Okay, so this is balloon number 1 and this is balloon number 2. So we will say S1 is equals to surface area of balloon whose radius is 7 centimeter. Okay, so that is first one. And S2, surface area of balloon whose radius is 14 centimeter. Okay, increases from 7 centimeter to 14 centimeter. Okay, so 14 centimeter means this second one. Okay, so here we have to find out total surface area. Okay, so S1, first we will find out S1 is equal to 3 pi r square. Okay, so radius, this is first radius is 7 centimeters. So here we can say R1 also. Understood? So now I am taking here pi, I am keeping as it is because finally we have to find out ratio. So definitely pi will be cancelled. Understood? So now here 3 pi multiplied by R is radius of first hemisphere, hemispherical balloon is 7 centimeters. So 7 centimeter square. So 7 square. Understood? 7 square centimeters. So 3 pi 7 square into centimeter square. So this is the surface area of first balloon. Okay, so that is total surface area. Now we will find out S2. Okay, S2 is equal to again the same formula because that is also closed, 3 pi r square. Okay, so here also I am keeping 3 pi as it is. So 3 pi multiplied by radius is, what is the radius of next balloon? That is 14 centimeter square. Okay, now we have to find out ratio. Okay, we have S1, that is total surface area of first balloon and surface area of second balloon, and we have to find out ratio of the surface area. So finally we can do S1 upon S2 is equal to 3 pi into 7 square divided by 3 pi into 14 square. Okay, so here 3 pi, this will be cancelled. 7 square means what? 7 multiplied by 7 upon 14 multiplied by 14. So 7 ones are 7, 7 twos are 14, 7 ones are 7, again 7 twos are 14. So what is remaining here? 1 upon 4. Okay, so ratio is S1 is to S2 is equals to 1 is to 4. So required ratio is 1 is to 4. Okay, so here one thing we need to see, that where we have to find out curved surface area and where we have to find out total surface area. If it is not given it directly, so we have to think it logically. Okay, so air is pumped into it, so definitely it is closed. So that's why we have taken their total surface area, that is 3 pi r square. So radius is different, so 3 pi we have kept as it is, so 3 pi will be cancelled, and 7 square, 7 into 7 upon 14 multiplied by 14. Okay, so 7 to the 14, 7 to the 14, so it will be 1 upon 4, so it will be 1 is to 4. So required ratio is 1 is to 4. ओके. और नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज अ स्फीयर, अ सिलेंडर एंड अ कोन आर ऑफ द सेम रेडियस एंड सेम हाइट. Find the ratio of their curved surfaces. Okay, we have to find out ratio of their curved surfaces. Okay, so what is given? See, a sphere, a cylinder, and a cone. Okay, so if you think about the figure, then here see, sphere. Then what is second one? A cylinder. And third one is a cone. Okay, there is a cone whose radius and heights are same. Understood? So here we have to find out ratio of the curved surfaces. So before that we need to think something. See here, suppose we will consider, let the radius of all the three figures, that is sphere, cylinder and cone b r units. Okay, r units. Okay, so it's suppose radius is r units. This radius is r units. Understood? So we have to express its height in terms of radius. Okay, so what will be the height of the sphere? Definitely 2 times radius, that is the diameter. Understood? So its height will be 2r, 2 times radius means 2r. And here they have told us a sphere, a cylinder and a cone are of the same radius and same height. Okay, means its radius is r, its also radius is r, so definitely height will be 2r. Its height also 2r. Height is 2r. Understood? Why 2r? Because radius of sphere is r, we have taken. So definitely the height means the diameter of the sphere. Okay, so that is the maximum height, that is r plus r, that is 2r. So if the height of sphere is 2r, then definitely the height of cylinder is 2r and height of cone is 2r. Okay, these things are required to find out curved surface area. Okay, so that is surface area. Okay, so first we will find out surface area, that is we will say S1 is the surface area of sphere. S1 is equal to surface area of sphere. Understood? So surface area of sphere, which formula we use? 4 pi r square. Understood? Here radius is r, so that is we have taken, so that will be the formula, that is only the last step of surface area of sphere. Understood? Now second thing, this is S1. Okay, second thing we will take S2, that is surface area of this cylinder. Okay, so what they are saying, find the ratio of their curved surfaces, huh? We don't have to think total surface. Here curved surface and total surface about sphere is same. Here we have to think curved surface of cylinder. Curved surface of cylinder we find out with the help of 2 pi rh. Okay, so that formula I am using here, 2 pi rh multiply by h. But what is the h here? 2r. What is h? 2r. So that I am going to replace here, that is 2 pi r multiply by 2r. Okay, so what will be the product of this? 2 into 2, 4, 4 pi r square, 4 pi r square. That is the second curved surface area, that is the curved surface area of cylinder. Understood? Now third thing we will find out, that is CSA of cone. CSA of cone. What is the formula to find out CSA of cone? CAC of cone is equals to pi RL. Okay, slanting height is required here. Okay, so we need to find out slanting height first. Understood? So L equals to under root R square plus H square. R square plus H square. Understood? So, R square will remain as it is because radius is same. R square plus H is, what is the H? 2R. Height of the cone is 2R. So, that I am taking here 2R square. Understood? So, now here under root R square plus 2R square will be 4R square. Okay, so finally addition 4R square plus R square will be 5 under root 5 R square. R square we can take outside, so your answer will be root 5 R. Root 5 R. To find out, we can find out. So I am going to find out here CAC. CAC is equal to pi R L. So that is 22 by 7. Radius is R as it is multiplied by slanting height is root 5 R. Root 5 R. Okay, so what is going to get here? Now 22 into or 5 value of pi we will not keep, then what we will get? Pi into R into root 5 R. Okay, so what we can write here? Root 5 pi R square. Root 5 pi R square. Okay, so this is our third answer. Now here we have to find out ratio. Okay, so here I am taking now that first one is S1 is 4 pi R square. 4 pi R square is 2. Again second one is 4 pi R square. And third one is root 5 pi r square. Okay, if you see common factor pi r square we can cancel. So what is remaining here? 4 is to root 5. Understood? So this is our final answer and that is required ratio. Once again see here carefully. A sphere, a cylinder and a cone are of the same radius and same height. Okay, find the ratio of their curved surfaces. Curved surfaces here we have to find out. So if you see radius, the height of the sphere will be 2 times of its radius. So height we have taken 2R. Okay, so here surface area of sphere is equal to 4 pi R square. So that formula will remain as it is. Now curved surface area of cylinder. Okay, so 2 pi R into H. So H is, what is H? H is 2 times R because the height is same of all the three figures. So 2R, so it will get 4 pi R square. Third thing is curved surface area of cone pi R L. So here we need to find out slanting height. So slanting height is equal to R square plus H square. R square plus 2R bracket square. So it will be 5 R square under root 5 R. Okay, we have to find out curved surface area. Curved surface area is equal to pi RL. So pi multiplied by R multiplied by root 5 into R because slanting height is root 5 R. So R into R, R square, root 5 pi R square. So finally we have to find out ratio 4 pi R square is to 4 pi R square is to root 5 pi R square. So pi R square is the common factor. It will be cancelled. So what is remaining? 4 is to root 5. So that is the required ratio and answer of this question. Okay, thank you.